Do you want it so bad if I asked you what your dreams were right now, you could close your eyes and you'd get emotional about it? I said, I'm coming through. Let me explain this. This is my company today. This was me back whenever I sold. I was in your same place. Behind me was my why, was my family, was my competition, who I knew I had to destroy. If you're not with me, you're against me, okay? I knew who I was. I knew what my values were. I knew who I was gonna become. You know what that's called? Momentum. Let me explain this. This weight behind the train, that is what pushes the train. Do you feel me? What pushes you? Guy in the green shirt, what pushes you? What pushes you? Let me ask you this. When you talk about it, does it piss you off? Do you want it so bad if I asked you what your dreams were right now, you could close your eyes and you'd get emotional about it? I want to ask you. You wonder why you're not winning, because you don't really want it. And I'm telling you the damn truth. Some of you, you're still not awake yet. You don't know what your dream is. I'm gonna tell you this. Let me tell you how to get in the zone, right? Dan, give me some music. Watch, let me show you something. Every morning, I sit there and I go into blackout mode. And I say, okay, I got my wife, I got my kids, I got my team. If I was to die right now, boom, got hit in a car wreck. I'm on the way to work. The paramedic says, you got 30 seconds to live, dude. You're done. Your guts are hanging out. You're done. What are you thinking about? What is it? At that point, what you would be thinking about is your why. Now you know what your why is. Your kids, your children, okay? Dude, it has to have something to do with, did you take care of them when you die? Will they have money to be able to be taken care of? Or are they f***ed? Are they on their own now? You thought you had this 5 more years to put together this plan that you were talking about for the last 5 years that you didn't do? You know what I'm saying? Guys, we're running out of time. And by the way, quit abusing the time. You want to know how to scale and grow fast? Be impatient. Be impatient. I call it aggressive patience. I don't have patience. By the way, successful people believe in timing. They believe in speed. Okay? Timing, now's the freaking time. Number two, speed. I need to figure out how to do it faster than my competition. Do you hear me? Think about it. I'm telling you the damn truth. Is this how your sales meetings go in your dealership? Probably not. Let me explain why, and let me tell you why. Because most of them have never maxed out their full potential. You guys follow other mentors in life? I sure hope you do. I would like to be one of them. I follow a guy named Ed Milet. He has a podcast, it's called Max Out. What he talks about is maxing out your potential. You know, most of the people that you work for have never maxed it out. They settled, they have a salary now, okay? Guys, do you know I have no salary? Don't want one. Salaries are cancer, don't want it. I like to start over at zero. Why? My life goes back to zero, I'm dangerous, okay? You give me a 50 grand salary, I won't work. I'm human, just like you. You feel me? Guess what happens? You guys all get paid off commission? Good, good, it's what makes you dangerous, okay? Once you decide to stop hunting, you know what happens? Your life's over, you're finished. A lot of people, they work their ways up through the ropes. They're doing the same thing that I'm talking about now. You were here with me in a seminar, Salvador. You took yourself to make it 25, 30 grand a month. You're 21 years old. You're like, man, this is f***ing crazy. Everything you said was going to happen. But now we need to go to 50 or 60. You don't think you deserve it. You're not capable of getting there. It's all here. Yes, you are going to have the skill. Yeah, you're going to have the skill for sure. But I'm going to tell you this. The way that you want to win and feel about your own life and believe that your own life is capable of doing these things, don't you think during negotiation or when you're talking to somebody, that same belief is necessary to show up? Don't you think it is? How could you doubt yourself and then expect to be a great closer? You're a fraud. No wonder everybody doesn't close with you.